So, Rego, I want to know, what's the mystery behind your name, the Rego B? Why Rego B?
So it is Rego B because my mom's name is Rema and my dad's name is Govind. So Ray for Rema and Govind for Go and B for Bansal, which is my surname. So Rego B is the name. So that's why we got this name.
That's such a cool name.
It's pretty cool.
Did you come up with the name, or who came up with the name? Your mom, dad, who?
My mama came with the name because when I was born, and my mama told me, so my real name is Swastik Govind Bansal. Mm-hmm. And my mama told me, why are you keeping a Panditji ka name? He's not going to be a Panditji. He's going to be a rock star. He's going to, all the crowd will say, Rego. So that's why he kept this name, Rego B. It's my nickname. So it's like my, I'm keeping this as my original name, Rego B.
Like Bappi Lahiri, right? That's one of the name, the iconic name. Now we have Rego B. So let's get started. Rego, your song is amazing, all right? It's already got 1 million plus views on YouTube and people are talking a lot of good things about it.
Thank you so much.
So tell me, how are your reactions? How are you consuming this love from the audience? What's going in your mind?
Actually, I'm very happy that my song has reached 1 million. And I cannot express my words. Like, I am so happy. Mm-hmm. And I cannot express my gratitude also that, my God, I was... damned, like, in 6 days? Are you kidding me? Like, 1 million? Okay. Bro, it takes like two weeks to reach 500,000, and mine's already reached six days 1 million. So it is very good, and I'm very happy, and this is how I consume my happiness.
I can see the energy flowing, man. You've got a great energy, you know. But बात करते हैं, मैंने कुछ पढ़ा था आपके बारे में कि ऑडिशन जब प्रोसेस हो रहा था आपका, आपने ये बात छुपाई रखी थी कि आप बप्पी लहरी जी के ग्रैंडसन हैं। ये बात काफी सच है, मुझे बताइए ऑडिशन में हुआ क्या था, मुझे थोड़ी स्टोरी जाननी है, बैक स्टोरी।
सो बिफोर सिक्स, सो ऑन एट मार्च So music composer Shami Tandon, he took an audition of 100 children. Okay. And in those 100 children, I was there. And then he loved my singing. He loved my attitude. I was singing a Queen song. We will rock you. Whoa. I was singing that song. And he loved my attitude. I was like stomping on the floor and I was wearing those chains. And he did not know that I am grandson of Bappi Lahiri, the greatest legend in the world. And he's the gold man of India. He was like, who's this Swastik Bansal? I want to call him. I want to call his mom. I want to say that I want him in my studio. And then he called my mom. And then he told her, hello, Rema. And my mom told her, he told her, is Swastik your son? And then my mom told her, yes, of course he's my son. And that time he knew that I was the grandson of Bappi Lahiri. And that's when he knew he knew that I got so much attitude and so much stylishment and hair and all this change and everything. So that's when my recording started of Bachcha Party. And now it is already released. I already went to 2 million views.
Okay, but why did you feel a need of hiding your identity? Like, you just wanted to be explored as a normal guy first and then go and explore yourself as Bappi Lahiri's grandson? That was the need?
Yeah, so actually, I don't want to show off that I'm Bappi Lahiri's grandson. Hey, I'm Bappi Lahiri's grandson. I am a rich guy's grandson. I can do whatever I want. I'm not like that. I don't want to be like that. I'm not dependent. I want to be independent. And then I wanted to hide my... identity because I never wanted people to say, "Arey, he's such a big man's this the grandson this and that and all those the things that that happens," and so my talent I'm learning so my talent is there and I wanted to say that. At the end only I want to show my identity. I don't want to show it before. I want them to know that who am I, this and that, and that's why this is how it is.
No, I get it. At such a young age, you have so much inspiration, you have so much energy, you have so much knowledge about how you should take your career forward. I'm really mesmerized by you, man. Okay, so let's talk about this. Have you started practicing with Bappi sir? Have you started that? Do you get any advices from him right now?
Oh yeah, of course. So I have always been there in my grandpa's recordings and his promotions, and even I do my singing practice every day, like every single day. And my mom and my grandpa takes my song every day. Mm-hmm. even if I sing an English song or a Hindi song or any other song, like they will and they want to hear my music. So my grandfather corrects me in every single thing, that how is the expression, then little more voice modulation, little more lower voice, little more expression, little more like very improvisations, and yeah variations, and to get a little more grooviness and all those things. Uh-huh. and that's what he always said, and that's why it's like that.
Okay, I get that. So I see a lot of Bapisa in you, okay? The way you style, the way you talk, the way you carry yourself, you know? So were you following from, like, when you were chota tha bachcha till now, you're just following him and you want to be like him, or you want to just create your own identity but also have a shadow in it? How is it going to be?
So I want to create my own identity. And I love the most of my grandfather's features, like he's the king of bling, bro. He's like so, I don't know what word is that, but he's so good. Like in everything, he makes everyone smile, he makes everyone happy, and he's the most humble person. Absolutely. I've ever met, and he's the most spiritual, and every day he does pranam to his mom and dad, Mr. Bansuri Lahiri, Mr. Alokesh Lahiri. From that I have learned that even every day, even I do pranam to my mom and dad. My mom is sitting right in front of me, Rema Lahiri, and my dad is sitting right there. So I love them the most. They're the best in the world. And yeah, and I want to make, and this is how my style is. I'm wearing those Jordan jackets and all those watches. I'm like my grandfather only. I follow my grandfather. I copy my grandfather the most. And my idols are Michael Jackson and his pop and his moves and his all those these things and all those this thing that I'm sitting now, so I can't do it.
Well, I saw you dancing in it. Okay, I saw you rapping in it. I saw you dancing in it. Wow, that's a flair that you have. So rapping is one of the things that you want to take forward as well.
Yep. I love rapping. I like contemporary music. I want to do singing also, but side by side rapping also. I love rapping. Yeah.
Who's your favorite rapper? Who do you follow? Who do you admire?
So number one, I like Lil Nas X.
Okay.
Lil Nas X, Kid Cudi.
Okay.
Then Polo G, XXXTentacion, and then Trippie Redd, the Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then Deja Vu and all those and all those great rappers. And
how about you throw some Indian names as well? Who are you following in Indian rapping scene? It's a quite big scene right now.
So I'm currently following Badshah right now because Badshah wear all those big jackets and all those style and he bounces so nicely in his dance, and that's why I learned at Badshah Party to bounce and to enjoy the flow of the music and to express how he dances and all the dance steps he does. Like, he doesn't do that much of dance, but his way of dancing, like in slow like that, I love his style. So that's why I'm currently following Badshah.
Okay, I see you also act in it. Okay, you've got a good acting skill as well. I have a flair of watching people when they act, you know. I like your acting. Are you looking forward to do some acting also in future, or what? What is it?
Yep. So actually, I want to be a singer come actor.
Okay.
So that is my dream come true. Like, I want to act in many big films, and I want to act in podcast series, and music is the bare only. Music is my lifestyle, and I love music the most, and that's how it is. I want to be a music come singer, and I want to be a full 4-in-1 package box. Like, whenever they open me, they'll see entertainment goes everywhere. It goes everywhere, and whenever they close me, no entertainment. Okay. And I'm like a box. Like when you tell me to do something, I will do it with my heart. So yeah, so everyone calls me entertainer. Like my mom always calls me.
Man, I love
you. My mom always calls me Chota Lara entertainer. Like,
okay, tell me, if I ask you if you want to recreate your grandfather's song, which will be that song that you want to recreate and do it along with him and collaborate with him, what will be that dream project of yours?
So the song which I want, so
yeah,
the song
which
I, So I want to recreate disco dance with my grandfather, and then he sang it so beautifully, composed it. He didn't sing it, sorry. He composed it so beautifully, and the music beats and everything. It's superb, and also the dancing step by Mithun Chakraborty was awesome. Like, it was mind blowing. And then my grandpa brought disco into India, and that's why I want to recreate Disco Dancer with my grandfather again, like Disco Dancer remix by Rego B and Bappi Lahiri.
We got the stamp on it. Ta-da. That's amazing, man. I had so much fun talking to you, man. Best of luck for the future, and I love the energy. Just keep it up, and I'm gonna see a lot of you in future. Best of luck. Yeah,
thank you so much. Thank you so much. All your blessings.
Have a good day.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir. Thank you.